You will not believe, but on May 27th, 2021, 30 years later of detecting the first Oh My God particle, again in the same region at the telescope array, the successor to the fly's eye detector stumbled across a similar bizarre and significantly powerful signal. This time it was detected by Toshiro Fuji, an astronomer from the Osaka Metropolitan University in Japan. The telescope array consists of 507 surface detector stations, arranged in a square grid that covers 700 km squared outside of the Delta, Utah, in the state's West Desert. The event triggered 23 of these detectors at the northwest region of the telescope array. This time, the event measured 240 exaelectron volts, lower in energy than the Oh My God particle, but still 5 times higher in energy than our understanding of the laws of the universe would suggest should be allowed. The finding was published just last week in the Journal of Sciences. I have added a link to the research paper in the description below, and it was recorded with a nickname, the Amaterasu particle, after the Japanese sun goddess. Amaterasu would be a familiar name to all of you Naruto fans out there. But again, when Dr. Fuji and his team tried to pinpoint the source of this particle, they could not find a viable candidate, which can be considered a source in the night sky. There was no explosion or cosmic event that seemed to be the culprit. So, what exactly is happening here? What are these particles and how are they moving so quickly? We'll dive in to understand this, but before that, let's see what had happened on the night of October 15th, 1991. Scientists were looking at the sky, as all of you who are watching this video love to do. They saw an unknown particle streaking across the Utah sky. The particle was going so fast that if it was in a race with a beam of light, it would have lost by a mere thousandth of the width of a human hair if the race went on for a span of a year. At this speed, it would take over 215,000 years for the photon to gain a 1 cm lead over the particle. The energy this particle contained was equivalent to dropping a bowling ball from chest height. All of this energy was contained in just a single particle. So understand this. This particle is so small that it isn't even visible to human eye. But if it would hit you, you'd surely be crushed. If you're saying, oh my god, so are the researchers who found it. And that's why it was called the Oh My God particle, the most powerful cosmic ray ever detected. That is until last week when a particle of similar power arrived at Earth from somewhere deep in space. But where are these particles coming from? What is causing them? And how can they possibly exist? An array of hundreds of spherical mirrors stud the ground at the fly's eye detector at Dugway Proving Ground in Utah. They picked up a faintly glowing trail of the Oh My God particle, a cosmic ray from space with an energy measured at 320 exaelectron volts, which is 40 million times more energy than even the Large Hadron Collider, the most powerful particle accelerator ever built by humans. It took 8 months to even see the signal in the data, since it appeared to be very different of what experts were used to seeing. Following that, the crew spent another year convincing themselves that the signal was genuine and not a result of a mistake on their instruments. This is because, as far as we can tell, a particle of this much energy is not feasible. Kenneth Grayson, Gregory Zatsupin, and Vadim Kuzmin calculated in the 1960s that any particle with an energy greater than 50 exaelectron volts, or roughly the energy of proton traveling at 99.999999999998% of the speed of light, should interact with microwave background radiation over long distances. Over this time period, this should act as slowing force on the particle. Because of the insane speed this particle traveled at, it experienced an extreme version of Einsteinian time dilation. If this particle originated from a distance of 1 billion light years, it would take approximately 1.5 days in the reference frame of the particle to travel that distance. Or in simple words, if it were aware of the time travel, it was just a short trip before it hit our planet. This GZK limit implied that the Oh My God particle was either impossible or had a recent and reasonably close origin. So it hadn't yet had a chance to slow down, presumably originating within one of our galaxy's local clusters. But when scientists turned other instruments to the calculated direction of the origin of these particles, nothing out of the ordinary was observed. But again, on May 27, 2021, 30 years later, scientists detected another particle like this, but this time with 240 xi electron volts, lower in energy than the Oh My God particle, which was published after all the observations just last week. Cosmic rays are a vast group of particles, but they are normally incredibly energetic atomic nuclei, usually only a photon or very rarely electrons, flying across space at speeds close to the speed of light. Every second, thousands of these cosmic rays impact every square foot of the Earth's atmosphere. However, they were first discovered in the early 1910s by Austrian scientist Victor Hesse, who climbed in a hot air balloon equipped with an ionizing radiation detector. He discovered that as his height grew, so did the amount of ionizing radiation. When Hesse proceeded to do similar experiment using a solar eclipse and found no reduction in ionizing radiation, he concluded that these particles must be coming from somewhere other than our sun. Cosmic rays went undetected for a long time because at sea level, only extremely low energy particles created by the secondary actions of cosmic rays impacting the upper atmosphere reach us to be studied. When cosmic rays enter the upper atmosphere, they sever the nuclei of oxygen and hydrogen gas molecules. These particles travel a short distance in our atmosphere before repeating the process, resulting in a shower of billions of secondary particles that scatter to the surface. The secondary showers had a gigantic footprint, requiring detectors to cover an area the size of the telescope array. The surface detectors make use of a range of instruments that provide researchers with information about each cosmic ray. The timing of the signal shows its trajectory, and the amount of charged particles hitting each detector reveals the primary particle's original energy. Since 1991, the astrophysics community has developed better detectors to understand high-energy cosmic rays arriving at Earth. Between 2004 and 2007, the Pierre Auger Observatory detected 27 events with energies above 50 xi electron volt mark, with the Amaterasu being the second highest energy particle detected since 1991. So, we know this isn't a one-off event or that it's a bad data. But how could it be possible that these particles are reaching speeds so close to the speed of light? The main theory suggests that particles are being accelerated by shock accelerations from sources like solar flares, neutron stars, or supernova events. This causes an accelerating front of ionized heated matter called plasma to move faster than the speed of sound in the particles, causing them to form an expanding pressure wave. Some particles become trapped between the particle front and the magnetic field, bouncing between them and eventually finding a gap and then escaping into space. However, we haven't seen these explosions in the night sky yet, as light doesn't typically arrive simultaneously with the particles. So, what is actually happening here? The telescope array in Utah has been observing the source of some high-energy cosmic rays, which are correlated with extragalactic supermassive black holes, AGNs, at the center of nearby galaxies. These AGNs emit significant energy across the electromagnetic spectrum, from radio to gamma ray wavelengths, which is theorized to result from the accretion of matter into a supermassive black hole at its core. This radiation produces high electric fields and a continuous ion source, making them feasible candidates for producing ultra-high energy cosmic rays. However, only some of these particles seem to hit these high speeds. Alternative theories suggest that active galactic nuclei can convert dark matter into high-energy protons. Astrophysicists are generally confused about what is happening, but the large telescope array is expanding its footprint to 2,900 square kilometers, adding 500 new scintillator detectors to better understand the origin and nature of these particles. What do you think could be the source of these near light-speed cosmic rays? Let me know in the comments below. And if you like this episode, check out a video I did not too long ago about a mysterious signal arriving from 8 billion light years away. Thanks very much for watching. I'll see you guys next time.